A very good morning to all my dear students of class 7. This is the second class on the drama The Bet, written by Jules Verne, the famous French author. In yesterday's class, I have discussed with you about the plot construction of dramas as much as I thought required for you at this stage, that means in 7th stanza. And we were introduced to the characters of this drama, and I taught you up to scene 3. Today I will start teaching you from scene 4. So now Mr. Fogg, who agreed to the bet that he would complete his journey around the world within 80 days, is now ready, and he had started his journey with Passepartout, and they are now in India. So scene 4, Mr. Fogg and Passepartout are in India. Narrator: the Fogg and Passepartout had travelled to a few places and are now on their way to Allahabad. They are crossing a forest. Their elephant suddenly stops and they hide themselves and watch a funeral procession. A young woman dressed in heavy jewelry walks with unsure steps behind a hearse. A hearse is a coffin sort of thing, a vehicle used to carry a coffin to a funeral. So the scenario is something very much oriental. Oriental means related to the east. East means India and the eastern parts. Okay, so they have reached Allahabad in India. There they have found a lady who was very much tensed, and who was having unsure steps, and she was following a hearse. Mr. Fogg: they are going to kill this woman. You must save her. Passepartout: sir, the clock is ticking and your bet. Mr. Fogg: surely I can devote a little time to saving a woman from certain death. Now we just need a plan. Think, Passepartout. So Mr. Fogg had seen this custom, the oriental, the Indian custom of killing the woman with the funeral of her husband. They have found that, and this is, as I told you, a very 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 age old Indian or oriental custom, which is a very bad social practice prevalent at that time. Now Mr. Fogg wanted to save the life of that woman. Passepartout reminds him that they are time bound. They have to finish their journey, and they cannot spend any time. But Mr. Fogg had resolved that nothing is more important than saving the life of a woman whose death is evident, whose death is certain. Passepartout to himself: I have an idea. Why not? After all, it's a chance, perhaps the only one. Passepartout slips out. Mr. Fogg: we have to act quickly. Passepartout: Passepartout, where are you? Looking out frantically. Passepartout, panting and rushing in with the woman whose name is Oda. Let us be off, Oda. You have rescued me. I shall always be grateful. So they quickly had a plan. Passepartout slipped out, and somehow they managed to take the lady Oda with them. And now Oda is very much grateful to Mr. Fogg and Passepartout. Narrator: Oda accompanies them on the rest of the journey. After many nail-biting adventures traveling around the world, Mr. Fogg, Oda and Passepartout finally reach Liverpool, England at 11:40 a.m. on 21st December. They are only 6 hours away from London and from winning the bet. And all this time Mr. Fix was also following Mr. Fogg. He is waiting to get onto British soil to arrest Mr. Fogg, and does so in Liverpool. Poor Mr. Fogg is put into jail, and his hopes of winning the bet come crashing down. Soon it is clear that Mr. Fix has made a mistake. However, is it now too late to win the bet? So they were on their journey. Initially they started the journey, Mr. Fogg and Persifer Tot, but later on they took Odda with them, the lady, and one detective whose name is Mr. Fix, about whom we have got the information in scene 3, was constantly following them because he wanted to resolve the matter of the bank robbery that happened when they started their journey. And Mr. Fix was waiting for them to reach the English land, that means for them to reach England, so that he can arrest them. So he arrested them. They have reached Liverpool in 11:40 a.m. They were very close to reaching their place where they were supposed to reach, but he was arrested and he had lost all hope of winning the bet. So they were just 6 hours away from London. Let's see what happens. But Mr. Fix will gradually will have understood that he was forming a misconception that Mr. Fogg is the criminal, which he would later on identify and recognize to be his mistake, and they would leave him. Okay, let's see what happens. Scene 5. Mr. Fogg and Odda took very sad and dejected. Mr. Fogg and Odda look very sad and dejected. Mr. Fogg, I'm so sorry it is now too late to reach the club in time to win the bet. I am a poor man, Odda, but I welcome you to my house. Persifer Tot, wishing into the room. Mr. Fogg must hurry. Mr. Fogg, what is the matter? Persifer Tot, I have just found out today is Saturday. Mr. Fogg, Saturday? Impossible. Yes, yes, you have made a mistake of one day. We arrived 24 hours ahead of time. Mr. Fogg, how did that happen? It was quite sure it is Sunday. Odda, never mind that now. Let's hurry. Persifer Tot then seizes his master's hand. So they thought that they have reached the English soil one day later, because they were mistaking with the idea, because they were traveling around the world. They have not realized that they are one day ahead of the time they are thinking of. Okay, so it was not Sunday, it was rather Saturday. And Mr. Fogg is now trying to apologize to Odda that he could not properly welcome Odda to his land. Scene 6, 8:20 p.m. on 21st December 1872. There are four gentlemen standing near the card table in the card room at the Reform Club. These are the men who made the bet with Mr. Fogg, and they are bankers John Sullivan, Samuel Fallentine, Andrew Stewart, an engineer, and Goodyear Ralph, the director of the Bank of England, and all of them are looking at the clock, which shows 20 minutes past 8. One man enters the room briskly. This is Thomas Flanagan, a brewer. Who is a brewer? Who makes a drink from barley. A brewer is a person who makes a drink out of barley. Mr. Stewart, getting up from his chair and walking towards the clock. Well, gentlemen, in 25 minutes the time agreed upon between Mr. Fogg and ourselves would have passed, and we will know if Fogg has won or lost. So there were only a few minutes left for that particular time to reach. The bet that set and which was admitted by Mr. Fogg, there is only a little bit of time left. Mr. Flanagan, what time did the last train arrive from Liverpool? Mr. Ralph, at 23 minutes past 7, and the next one doesn't get here till 10 past 12. Mr. Stewart, well, gentlemen, if Phileas Fogg had come in by 7:23 train, he would have got here by now. We can therefore consider the bait as won. Mr. Fallentin, let's not be so hasty. You know, Mr. Fogg is very eccentric. Eccentric means a mad sort of person. His punctuality is well known. He never arrives too soon, nor too late. I shouldn't be surprised if he appeared at the door at the last minute. Mr. Stewart, why, if I saw him now, I would not believe it. So they knew that their friend, Mr. Fogg, is such a person who is so punctual that who does not reach a place before the time or after the time. He just is so punctual. He maintains time so minutely that he reaches a place at the proper time. Mr. Flanagan, Mr. Frog's project was absurdly foolish. Whatever his punctuality, he could not prevent the delays which were certain to occur. Mr. Sullivan, we have received no news of him at all. There are telegraph lines all along his route. Telegrams have been sent to America and Asia, but no one has heard anything of them. Mr. Stewart, the China, the only steamer on which he could have got here, arrived yesterday. His name was not on the passenger list. He has lost, gentlemen, only 5 minutes. So they at those time, the only medium of communication was telegram. So they have tried to make contacts with other countries from where he must have started his journey. But his friends did not get any hint about him. Only there is one hope that a ship comes from China, which was about to reach London the day before. Might be he was in that. Mr. Stewart, the China, the only steamer on which he could have got here, arrived yesterday. His name was not on the passenger list and he has lost, gentlemen, only 5 minutes more. All look at each other. The tension is unbearable, which we cannot bear is unbearable. They became restless. Mr. Flanagan, in an attempt to break the tension, shall we play a rubber while we wait? All silently agree. As the cards are shuffled, all their eyes are on the clock, which ticks away loudly in an absolute silence. Mr. Ralph, as the cards are dealt 18 minutes to mine, the players pick up and cards and arrange them. Mr. Flanagan looks up the clock. 2 more minutes. There is a total silence in the room except for the ticking of the clock and the muffled sound of the crowd from outside. So only 2 minutes were left. Everywhere it was pervading silence. Only the ticking of the clock was heard. Mr. Sullivan, with suppressed excitement, 60 seconds to win. The players now stop playing and silently count of the seconds. At 57th second, there is a roar of hooray from the crowd outside. The players rise to their feet. Almost immediately, the door opens as Mr. Phileas Fogg appears, followed by a crowd of people. Mr. Fogg, here I am, gentlemen. Mr. Sullivan, so you are Fogg. Mr. Ralph, you have won, not a second to spare. So this is the final moment for them. Just 60 seconds were left, and at that terminal time Mr. Fogg had reached. They all shake hands, talk among ourselves. Narrator, yes, Mr. Fogg won the bait, but how could he have mistaken the day? Why did a person who is so punctual not realize that he had reached a day early? Well, the cause of the error is very simple. Phileas Fogg had, without realizing it, gained 1 day on his journey because he had constantly travelled eastward. In journeying eastward, he had gone towards the sun and therefore gained 4 minutes for every degree of longitude, and he crossed in this direction. They are there 160 degrees on the circumference on the arc, and this 360 degrees multiplied by 4 minutes gives precisely 24 hours. That is 1 day, and that is how Phileas Fogg went around the world in 80 days and won the bait of £20,000. So here again you will know about a little bit of calculation of geography, because he had started his journey eastward, and in the process 360 degrees into 4 minutes. So he has gained a day. Okay. he has gained a day. We know now that there is a standard time of each and every country, and if we make our journey towards east, we proceed in our time. If we make our journey towards west, then the time is decreasing. Okay, naturally, if we go to Bangladesh, Myanmar, Thailand, Japan, so we will move towards the east and the time is ahead of us. If we go Pakistan, Afghanistan, Dubai and westward, the time will be less than Indian standard time. We know that. So that is what had happened. So I hope, students, it's a good drama for you to start at this age. I have tried to explain it to you. Please read it time and again, several times, in order to enjoy. You know, students, if we were in the proper classroom scenario, I would have told you to do role play. I would have made somebody Sullivan, somebody Mr. Fogg, somebody Oda, and all these things I would have made in the class. But at this moment, it's not possible. You read it aloud at home, and if you can manage to have somebody at home, tell them to read that part, because drama teaching is something which should be done in a different manner, which we generally do. Role play, voice modulation, all these things are very much required. I have tried to read it myself. You just hear it, then you read it, underline the unknown words, read it. So this is the last chapter from your Living English book. The syllabus from this book is done. Only one chapter is left from Arabian Nights, which is also a very known story to you, about Aladdin. Okay, so that I will start tomorrow or in the next class. And in the next class, the time, I have almost completed 20 minutes. So the question answer discussion I have to do in the next class. So read it, go through it. If you have any problem, feel free to tell me by class. And follow the next class for question answer discussion, and I will give you the answers also. Okay, bye.